Okay, show's about to start. Your 15 minutes of fame starts now. Ladies and gentlemen, you probably don't believe it because of the act, the stick. But I'm nervous. But recently I heard some words of wisdom from the great American jazz mandolinist, Jethro Burns, who after performing for 60, 70, 80 years, would get in front of an audience like this, and a hostile audience, and say, and say, you know, folks, I'm so nervous that I know I'm going to screw up my first song, so I'm going to start with my second song. And that's what I'm going to do tonight. I'm going to take his advice and start with my second song, which is actually the first song that I ever wrote, ladies and gentlemen. It's got three chords. I bet you know what they are. And you could help me out on it, too. I was sitting in a cottage on the Oregon coast. I looked out the window. There was my landlady, Mrs. Tolleson, taking out her garbage. And I said, son.
Plug in, plug in.
Are you plugging in? See the other end of this?
I can't help you.
He told me. Sound dude told me that he would do that for me.
I did not tell you
that. Oh, shut up! I'm starting my clock over.
My fault.
Yeah. Well, now I don't even know what key I am. What? C. Mrs. Thompson is taking out her garbage. She's stinking up the whole entire place. Miss Tolleson's taking out her garbage, and she's got a nasty look upon her face. Well, a trail of coffee grinds tags behind her as she steps on eggshells crushed beneath her feet. And the hungry crows are ready for a tree. You know, the bridge goes like this. Mrs. Thompson is taking out her garbage. She's stinking up the whole entire place. Mrs. Thompson is taking out her garbage. And she's got a nasty look upon her face. Well, the odds are 5 to 1. She won't make it to the garbage can. Waits just down the street. Bottom of the bag is giving way now. And it looked as though the culprit was some beets. You know how beets are like that? Because Mrs. Thompson is taking out her garbage. She's sticking up the whole entire place. Yeah, Mrs. Thompson is taking out her garbage, and she's got a nasty look upon her face. Here's the sad conclusion. She kneels beside the worst thing that could happen. A chicken carcass stares up in disbelief. Tears begin to cascade from her eyes now, and she vows to use a plastic bag next week. True story. A Miss Thompson taking out her garbage. She's stinking up the whole entire place. Yeah, Mrs. Thompson is taking out her garbage, and she's got a nasty look upon her face. I turn to Gerald Ross to the stage, please. Let me turn to Gerald Ross. Yay. Here's a little tune called the Lower Columbia River Blues. Give me a little reverb on that sound, dude.
Reverb.
And I keep this plugged in, right?
Oh, yeah.
Bass. Ladies and gentlemen, you probably don't know it, but I am an unpublished writer. I'd like to share a couple of selections tonight from my recently unpublished book, Adventure and Failure. I'll start with this one. Up Your Coast. San Francisco and I had a falling out. We decided I would be the one to leave. I'd like to invite my friend Little Rev to the stage, ladies and gentlemen. Little Rev to the stage, ladies and gentlemen. And the only reason I'm inviting Little Rev to the stage, ladies and gentlemen, is because this is the Midwest Ukulele and Harmonica Camp and not the Ukulele and Midwest Kazoo Camp. Yes, something like that. Because he just happens to have a harmonica. Here's a little song called The Harmonica Rag with the lyrics from Del Rey. Perspective. All I wanted to accomplish was to examine the human condition under a new light. I replaced the low watt bulb for my desk lamp with one of the high beam headlights from my car. My new high beam perspective shed intense illumination on the issues, yet cast a pessimistic shadow over my writing.
The words emanating from my typewriter could not alter the hate of a racist, stop the production of nuclear weapons, nor cleanse the earth of pollution. I could also not legally drive at night. Look for this in the fall. I'd like to bring up a couple of close friends of mine. They're going to stand right over here. Heidi Swetberg and Victoria Vox, ladies and gentlemen. So, yep, ladies, we have 3 minutes and 32 seconds. A 5 minute song. Well, I'm going to take an extra minute because of what you have this whole... Okay, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, I wrote this song because, you know, blogging is so popular, and I thought, well, God, a song about blogging would be twice as popular.
Here she is.
It doesn't matter what I have to say. I write it down anyway. I write my blog. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Can you hear what I say? I write my blog
every day.
Oh, you can help on that part. That would be nice, won't it? I close the curtains while I sit and write. I have no idea if it is day or night. I write my blog. Yeah, this is where we rehearsed it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I write my blog. Make up lists that are important to me. My favorite foods and what's on TV. I write my blog. Yeah, 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 I write my blog. Can you hear what I say? I write my blog.
Every day.
They're getting better as it goes along, aren't they? I wish this was 10 minutes long. My girlfriend left me because I don't go out. Give me more material to blog about. I write my blog. Yeah, 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 I write my blog. Can you hear what I say? I write my blog.
Every day.
Bridge. Every day, I write my blog. Whether or not I've got something to say. Well, I just write it anyway. Let me tell you about my beautiful dog and about the time we went for a jog. He got off leash, lost in the fog. Check out my site, I write updates each day. It may be pointless, but what the heck? I write my blog.